like and what we don't. We get attached to people mostly, sometimes animals. But it's not uncommon to favour one being to another. We might cry at thunder, or smile as sunlight dapples the carpet, slowly building the knowledge of our being. But what influences us most is the materials given to us. Toys may seem menial, a great joy to adults to keep us distracted for at least an hour or two, but they, with their plastic bodies and musical buttons, build the very foundations of the path of life impressed upon us. From personal experience, as they understand there are exceptions, there have been two breeds of data from which the majority of society will take to, a format if you like. These two formats differ, as stereotypes do. These formats act as protocol for many things, clothes, toys, nappies even. I need not go into detail of these formats, as I'm sure we are all aware of them. And of course, additionally, we are all aware of how these formats are appointed, by the contents of our pants, or how our bodies will react to puberty. Nothing more. Though they may seem harmless, these influences can imprint many things upon a child. Cans and can'ts, do's and don'ts. And what then if a child doesn't wish to fulfill these stereotypes? What if the boy wants to don dresses and the girl make the World Cup? How can we expect children to grow healthily into their true selves? How can they extract knowledge from resources around them in order to build character? If those resources are the very things confining them to the thick walls of societal pressure. Societal pressure created by rich white men back in the early years, impressed upon their wives as they expected dinner on the table and sex on demand. How can we live by those formats? And how is still nothing changing?
Thank you.